Now to getonline.com/livewire.
Hey, Wendy Townsend hanging out with us.
Yes.
Fishhead Cantina tonight in Arbutus. It's an absolutely free comedy show. Who's going to be on the bill with you?
A bunch of people. I don't know. Dave Schiffer told me, but I know Kat Timpf is hosting the show, and I know Haywood Turnip Scene Jr.
Kat Timpf.
Nice.
Hey, did you see her on Fox News?
Yes. Didn't she look great?
She looked incredible, and she was really good.
Really nice, yeah.
She's like a talking head. Who does she work for? Conservativesomething.org?
Yeah, it was
campusreform.org.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's like a reporter for them.
Have less sex in college?
You know, I honestly don't know anything about it. I'm going to have to ask her later.
Campus reform.
I'm going to be like, why did you stop smoking up and put on a dress?
She's like the biggest hippie ever. The conservative movement is getting railroaded.
We're going to ban the hacky sacks.
Yeah, guess so, Kat. You're like a double spy in there.
Yeah. The first time I met her, she's like, I think you kind of want to make out with me right now. I was like, I don't know. What? Hi.
Like, hi, nice to meet you.
Like,
how did you know?
I was like, God, she is in my head.
Now, Wendy, we've gotten to know you pretty well over the last, I'd say, year or so.
Yeah. And, that is accurate.
You know a lot of folks that are friends of the show, then weren't friends of the show, and then are friends of the show again.
Are you talking about Joe and Rob?
RobandJoeShow.com.
Forgive and forget, guys. Forgive and forget.
Yeah, well, you were on the podcast, and I finally came to a realization. Every time they have a woman on that podcast, they just take them out.
A woman.
Yeah, but so exactly. I guess I would like to say yes, but I got defensive, and I feel pretty bad for Jada Robinson right now.
Why? What did you do? Oh, this is going to be great. Tell me you destroyed him.
I just tried to, at least. I mean, I was nailing him. Like, at every turn, I was like, you have your own version of the truth. Throughout, like, just... Please stop talking.
Well, that's his humor though,
and
I like it a lot. I think it's pretty funny. You know, well, I don't know.
Yeah, I genuinely do like Joe Robinson.
Of course.
I don't think that he realizes how he speaks or how he comes across to people until they confront him.
But it's for the show.
Yeah.
Right.
Hey, no, Wendy, come on, Wendy, listen.
I know, come on.
Yeah, Wendy.
I just want to be right.
I didn't listen. No, that's not what I'm saying.
He definitely had to backpedal because he was like, no, that's not what I said. I'm like, go look at you. Four episodes ago, Joe Robinson,
right.
You said this.
I love it, terrible part.
For the thousands of people that didn't hear
and
the Rob
and
Joe show.
Yeah.
RobandJoeShow.com. Throw it out there a couple times. If you want to give this a listen, I'm sure you can find the Wendy Townsend show up on their website. Website,
it is live tonight at 7:30.
So when did they get you? What did Rob come after you for? Or I'm sorry,
well,
Joe.
Well, they didn't really... Well, Joe is infamous for saying that my relationship wouldn't work out, which in fact it did not. And I knew.
No,
I knew that when I got on that podcast, he was going to be like,
hey,
I
Wendy.
Told you so.
Hey, I'm not trying to start anything, but are you still dating that guy?
Yeah.
Oh, really? You broke up?
And then he tried to play it like that. I really, you know, I genuinely feel bad, you know? And I'm like, no,
he does, though. No, that's where you're wrong.
He genuinely
is a good guy.
And I get that.
He just has... Like me, verbal diarrhea. He can't control when he feels like he has to say something.
A lot of times, though, it comes across as very just rude.
I don't mind it.
Because like, if you're going to sit there and tell somebody that their relationship isn't going to work out.
But if you say why.
And then you invite him up on the show. And then you're like, and then you push him into going,
the problem
oh,
is
what
is
happened?
He said it when he first met me. Like, he first met Mike.
Because of
like,
the reason. No comic. Relationships, it's like one in a million,
which I understand, but the comedy part of the relationship was not even the issue. It was like so
something else, right?
Yeah, it was like completely
because
I get
here's why
out, but
babes, it has nothing to do
babes.
It has nothing to do with
yeah,
comedy.
Like my dad.
It has to do with who comedians are.
Yeah.
We're the most selfish, insecure, narcissistic.
Yep.
Look at me, I'm the center of attention people.
All
and then
the
when you expect two of those people to come together and you're trying to
come
get
together.
What you need from the other, it's impossible.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then for Joe to say that and then you come up on the show and then he sits there and he kind of needles you the entire time that he can be right.
Listen, Joe is married to the nicest woman on earth.
And he ruined that.
And she couldn't take him.
Well, he was apologetic. And I mean, like, I genuinely love Joe Robinson. I do.
How do you not?
I do.
Right.
But I mean, it was just the whole podcast got turned into, like, because I'm a woman, I guess, everything was sexual. They wanted to, like, quiz me on who I would sleep with now and, like, who I would date. And
did
I was
they
like,
ask if you and I ever hooked up?
No.
See,
but they did say, me, Rob was like, me, Bicky, and Joe, you know, in that order. And I was like, well, Joe first, get him out of the way.
Right.
And then they were like, no, by favorites. And I'm like, by favorites, Mickey, Rob, and Joe. And then they, literally, this is their response. We're okay with that. That's okay. No, we're okay with that. Yeah. I'm like, can you ask me about anything else?
Because the last female...
Who's sitting on you now, Wendy? What are you going to do, Wendy? I'm like, man, I'm just... My dad could be listening. You just think I'm some big, crazy slut face.
Big, crazy slut face.
That's the name of Wendy's first CD.
Yeah.
Wendy Townsend, Big, Crazy Slut Face.
Dad, I love you.
Or just slut face.
Oh. Is Dad listening?
Of course he is.
You got the best dad on the planet. That man loves you so much.
I know.
And he goes and watches these filthy little daughters say these horrible things.
The crazy part is he'll tell the audience, like, if he's sitting near anybody.
That's my girl.
That's a true story.
That's a true story.
True story.
I used that razor.
I'm like, Dad.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah. He is that guy.
I still got it. I still got the razor.
Put it in a box with a plaque.
So on the Rob and Joe show, so he only needled you for a little while, though. It wasn't the entire podcast,
yeah,
right?
But you can tell he was, like, underlining it with, I just want to be right.
Yeah, exactly.
Of course. He was right. I will give him that, but it was like, come on, man.
Listen, but didn't I tell you that night, too, when you got all upset? I'm like, Wendy, here's the situation.
Yeah.
Right.
And you know I have nothing but love for you.
I understand that, but no girl, like when a girl gets into a relationship.
I know they don't want to hear why it's not going to work.
They're just like, right. No, I'm going to have his pretty babies. Like,
right.
We're going to be married and have a big house and it's going to be wonderful. And that's
right.
Exactly.
How old are you?
30.
Ooh. See, here's the problem.
Oh, Amelia.
Am I all dried up? Am I all dried up?
That's the worst thing.
Another 14 years.
I don't think so. I think I got like six.
No. If you're lucky.
You can have babies into your 40s. It just gets a little more dangerous.
Birth defects and, I don't know. I can't give...
Well, it's not like they wouldn't have birth defects earlier. You just don't know. It's a big crapshoot anyways.
I don't know. I've never been pregnant.
Thank... Knock on something, Wendy. Your dad just went like this. All right.
He's like, where'd that $200 go that I paid for an abortion? I was late on my car payment.
And I didn't want to tell you, so I told you I was getting an abortion instead. Oh, my God.
I knew you'd give me the money.
That's pretty bad.
There's no way you could have said no to me.
Yeah, because you know he's going to say no. You can fix your own damn car.
Yeah, your car. What?
You co-signed for it. Yeah.
He won't fix your car, but he will fix you.
Hey, man, hold on. Your car's late. That's on you. Pregnant. How much you need?
Yeah. StudyItOnline.com.